हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रोफेसर मिहिर शाह वंस अगेन विद अनदर वीडियो। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द वेरियस बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ डायरेक्ट टैक्स फॉर द असेसमेंट ईयर 2020-21। नाउ बिफोर लर्निंग द बेसिक कंसेप्ट, लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट टैक्स एंड वेरियस कंसेप्ट रिलेटिंग टू डायरेक्ट टैक्स। So the very first thing which comes in our mind when we talk about direct tax is that when Income Tax Act was established. Number one, the Income Tax Act was established in the year 1961. The income tax rules were established, however, in 1962. Therefore, the levy of income tax in India is governed by the Income Tax Act of 1961 and the Income Tax Rules of 1962. The next question that comes in the mind is, what is the purpose of levy of taxes? Why do we need to levy tax? The taxed are the basic sources of revenue for the government. The revenue raised from the taxes are utilized for meeting the expenses of governments, like the provision of education, infrastructure facilities such as road, dams, etc. So all the expenses, all the public expenses that government needs to provide, okay, all those expenses are funded due to the reason of the revenue collected from the point of view of taxes. The taxes are collected for serving the primary purpose of providing sufficient revenues to the state. The taxes have come to be recognized as an instrument through which the social and economic objectives of a welfare state could be achieved. Okay, now the next question that comes into the mind is, who is responsible for collection of income tax? A simple answer to this is, the responsibility for collection of income tax vests with the central government. Now, what are the various types of taxes that government imposes? The government imposes two types of tax, namely direct tax and indirect tax. The direct tax is one where the burden of tax is directly on the payer. For example, income tax, wealth tax, etc. Suppose, we'll take an example to understand this. Suppose Mr. Joseph is the owner of manufacturing concern. He comes under the ambit of payment of income tax. Then the tax will be levied on Mr. Joseph only, as direct tax are levied on individuals. For calculation of his tax liability, income tax slabs will be used. The next type of tax which is imposed by the government is the indirect tax. Now, what is indirect tax? Indirect tax is paid by the person other than the person who utilizes the product or service. For example, the excise duty, custom duty, GST, sales tax, value added tax, etc. For example, when we buy or purchase a recharge coupon, we also pay GST. For example, for a recharge of rupees 20, we get talk time of rupees 14 sometime. Here, rupees 6 is deducted as the indirect tax. However, in this video, we are only going to learn about direct tax and what are the various concepts or various definitions of direct tax. So let us try to understand what are the various important definitions under direct tax. The very first definition that we need to learn is person under section 2 subsection 31. Now, when we say who has to pay tax, we always say a person needs to pay tax. But as per the direct tax, person includes many more things. So let us see what is person according to direct tax. As per section 2 subsection 31, a person includes number 1, individual, It refers to a natural human being, whether male or female, minor or major. So person includes individual people. Second, Hindu undivided family, also known as HUF. It is a relationship created due to the operation of the Hindu law. The manager of HUF is called the Karta and his members are called co-parsnas. So even a HUF is termed as person in direct tax. Third, a company. It is an artificial person registered under the Indian Company Act of 1956 or any other law. So even a company comes under person. Fourth, firm. It is an entity which comes into existence as a result of a partnership agreement. The income tax accepts only these entities as firm, which are assessed as firm under section 184 of the Act. So when we talk about a person, an individual, a HUF, a company and a firm, they all come under the heading person, then they are all eligible to pay direct tax. Other than these four, the next what is included in person is association of person, also known as AOP. When multiple persons combine together to carry on a joint enterprise and they do not constitute partnership under the ambit of law, they are assessable as an association of person. An AOP can have firms, can have companies, association and individual as its member. The next type is called as body of individual. A body of individual cannot have non-individuals as its members. Only natural human beings can be the members of a body of individual. The next is local authority. The municipality, panchayat, cantonment board, port trust, etc. are called local authorities and they also come under the heading persons. And lastly, we have artificial judicial person. A statutory corporation like the LIC, university, etc. are called artificial judicial person and they are also included in the heading person. So to sum it up, one can say that person under direct tax includes an individual, a Hindu undivided family, a company, a firm, an association of person, a body of individual, a local authority, and every artificial judicial person. To understand the various types of person, let us take the following example. Determine the status of the following. Now here is a list of various persons which have been given. Let us try to identify what does each mean. Now the very first is Delhi University. The next is Microsoft Limited. Next, Delhi Municipal Corporation. Then we have Soyam Education Private Limited, Axis Bank Limited, ABC Group Housing Cooperative Society, DC and Co, firm of Mr. Dust and Mr. Clean, and lastly a joint family of Mr. Dirty, Mrs. Dirty and their son Mr. Dust and Clean. Now let us see what does each of these entities, what kind of person they are. So number one, the Delhi University is nothing but an artificial judicial person. So yes, they are entitled to pay the direct tax. Microsoft Limited comes under the heading a company. Delhi Municipal Corporation is a local authority. Soyam Education Private Limited comes under the heading a company. Axis Bank Limited, also a company. ABC Group Housing Cooperative Society. Now here there are different persons which have come together, so it is an association of persons. DC and Co, a firm of Mr. Dust and Clean, is a firm or a partnership firm. And lastly, a joint family That is nothing but a Hindu undivided family. With this, the definition of a equivalent, the next what we need to learn is the concept of income under Section 2, Subsection 24. Now, in common parlance, income is known as a regular periodic return to a person from his activities. So, whatever you earn, that is nothing but your income. However, the income has broader classified in income tax law. The Income Tax Act even takes consideration of income which has not arisen regularly and periodically. For instance, winning from lotteries, crossword puzzles, income from winning of shows is also subject to tax as per the income tax. So any consideration in the form of rupees, okay, which you get regularly or irregularly is termed as income under the Income Tax Act. The next concept is the assessment year under Section 2, Subsection 9. Now, what is assessment year? Assessment means the year in which income of the previous year of the assessee is taxed. So, in the year in which you're going to calculate tax of the previous year, that year is called the assessment year. The time lapse of assessment year is of 12 months, beginning from 1st April every year. The period starts from 1st April of 1 year and ending on 31st March of the next year. Broadly, the assessment year is defined under Section 2, Subsection 9 of the Income Tax Act. And for this year, the assessment year will be 2020-21. Now, after the assessment year, the next concept is the previous year under Section 3. Now, the income earned during the year is taxable in the next year. The definition of previous year is given under Section 3 of the Act, which states that previous year is the year in which income is earned. Previous year is the financial year immediately preceding the relevant assessment year. So, if 2021 is the assessment year, the year which is preceding immediately was 2019-20. So, year in this case 1920 will become the previous year. From 1989-90 onwards, every taxpayer is obliged to follow the financial year, that is April 1st of 1 year to 31st March of the next year as the previous year. For this year, the previous year will be considered as 2019-20. Now, the next concept is the assessee under Section 2, Subsection 7. Now, what does this term assessee mean? Assessee means a person by whom any tax or any other sum of money is payable under the Act. So any person who has to pay tax, that person is termed as assessee. A person is liable to pay tax as well as interest if there is a late payment of tax or penalty for concealment of income or fraud under the Income Tax Act. Okay, now the last concept that we need to go through is the heads of income, which is under Section 14. Now, as per the Income Tax, Section 14 classifies income under 5 heads. So, if any person is earning any income through these 5 heads, they will be liable to pay the direct tax. So, the very first head of income is income from salary. So, if you earn salary, you have to pay tax. Second, income from house property. If you have a house property which you have rented, so the amount which you receive from that is again liable for taxation. Third, profit and gains of business and profession. If you have a business or you are a professional and whatever profit or gain you earn from it, that amount is also liable for taxation. Fourth, capital gains. if you have any capital which you have sold out and if you earn profit on that, okay, that amount is again liable for taxation. And last, income from other sources. Any other income which is not matching in these four heads will be considered as income from other sources. So these are the five heads of income which comes under the direct tax. So with this, the basic concept which comes under direct tax comes to an end. Thank you.